In this video, you'll learn how to get started with the DevExpress WinForms Grid Control. Locate the Grid Control component in the DX Data and Analytics tab on the Visual Studio Toolbox and drop it onto the form. Let's now use the grid to show data from a SQL Server database. First, choose a data source type. Select the database and click Next to proceed. In Choose a Database Model, select Data Set and click Next. Click the New Connection button to create a new database connection. By default, the data source type is set to Microsoft Access Database File. Let's click the Change button and choose a Microsoft SQL Server. In the dialog that appears, choose a server name and a database to connect to. In this example, we'll use the sample AdventureWorks database file. You can click Test Connection to check the connection. And finally, click OK. Now all you have to do is choose a data table for the grid to display. Let's select the Employees table. Let's uncheck the columns we won't need and click the OK button. And that's it. Let's run the application to see the result. Now you can see that the grid is ready to go with automatically generated columns and populated data. You get a fully functional grid control without writing a single line of code. End users can arrange and resize columns as they desire. To sort data against a column, click this column's header and click again to revert sorting order, ascending to descending. To apply a filter, click the filter button within the required column header. Note that the filter panel at the bottom allows you to customize the filter criteria even further. End users can also search for records containing required entries via the Find panel. To invoke this panel, press the Ctrl+F shortcut. These are just a few of the data shaping capabilities provided by the DevExpress WinForms Grid. Note that if you select the grid control, you can also access the settings that specify the control's positioning on the form and other generic control settings. The grid displays data and enables end-user interaction via view objects, so you need to select the view to customize how the grid looks and behaves. Click the view to display its properties within the Properties window. The grid view's main settings are grouped into several categories for your convenience. For example, the Options Behavior section allows you to fine-tune various functionality aspects of the grid. The Options Find section contains properties related to the search panel that we can enable by default by toggling the corresponding option. To customize element visibility and layout, use the Options View section. For example, set the Column Auto Width property to False to disable automatic column width adjustment to the view width. To customize specific column settings, select a column and modify the required properties in the Properties window. For example, you can anchor a column to the left or right edge so it never moves while scrolling through the grid. Yet another way to customize grid settings is via the Property Editor dialog. To invoke the dialog, click the corresponding link within the Grid Control Smart Tag. Let's group our data by the Title column. To add a summary item, invoke the Grid Designer. Switch to the Group Summary Items tab and click the plus button. Let's set the Field Name property to Title. Our data is grouped by this column, so leave the Show in Group Column Footer property unchanged. Finally, set the Summary Type property to Count. And let's run the application to see the result. Each group now contains a summary item that displays the record count for each group. You can use smart tags to access key properties of various grid elements, such as columns. Let's use this feature to specify in-place data editors for column cells. Select a column click the Smart tag, and locate the Column Edit property. Here, you can choose a previously used editor type or create a new one. Let's click the New node and select the required item from the list. You'll see Editor Settings under the Column Edit property, where you can specify the edit mask and display format for the recently assigned text editor. Now let's use the Level Designer in the bottom right corner of the grid to change the grid's data display format. Convert the grid view to Layout View. This view type will display separate cards for each record. You can change the card's layout via corresponding buttons at the view's top. One card, multiple cards, carousel, etc. Some grid control features are not view-specific and can be used in multiple or all views. For example, the Find panel invoked via the Ctrl+F hotkey allows you to search for records containing specific strings. Now you've learned all the basic ways to customize the grid control. Explore the Level Navigator, View and Column Settings, and the Property Editor dialog to find more settings. Learn even more at the DevExpress Documentation Center at help.devexpress.com. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.